Would you like to know what happened in the Edmonton real estate market last month? Then stick around because I'm going to break down the July 2019 market statistics for you right after this. Hi there. My name is Patrick Fields. I'm a realtor here in Edmonton, Alberta. If this is your first time here, hit that subscribe button and ring that bell to be notified when my next video comes out. I'm posting videos on buying tips, selling tips, neighborhood tours, and fun and interesting things to do around Edmonton. And I promise you, no Fortnite videos. So let's get into the July 2019 market statistics. We had 1,338 homes sell in July. That's an increase of almost 10% versus last year, and it's up 5.77% versus June, where we had 1,265 homes sell. We're now just over halfway through the year, and year to date, we've had 7,245 home sales. That's down just 1.28% from last year. To me, this means confidence is back in our market, and I expect sales to stay strong until that dreaded white stuff arrives. We have 6,617 homes for sale right now, and that's houses, condominiums, and duplexes. And that's down by nearly 13% from last year and down 3.6% from last month. And this is a trend that we would like to continue seeing to help balance our market. We've been battling excess inventory for well over a year now. So if we look at that inventory to sales, that's called our absorption rate, and it's just under 5 months right now. So that's if we take the total amount of homes that are currently on the market, divide by the number of sales for the last month, we get 5 months to sell off all the existing homes that are on the market if sales stayed the way they were and no new homes were listed for sale. So now if we look at prices, the average price paid for a single family home is up from June by 1.18% to $437,620, but that's a decrease of 3.12% from last year. Am I concerned about that? No. That's just the average that people paid in the month and maybe a few more lower priced homes sold, but 1% is really not anything to be concerned about. At least to me, the number of home sales was up, which is very encouraging. Condominium prices are down by 8% versus June and almost 12% from last year. The average sale price was $217,749. Again, we have had too much inventory in the condo department, and real estate is really supply and demand based. And prices fall when supply is high and demand is low. Duplex and row house prices are down 2.5% from last year and down marginally just over 0.25% from June to $343,000 in July. So what does all this mean? If you're a buyer, there's a lot of homes to look at, and you can probably still get a really good price on one. Interest rates are just under 3%, and the confidence really seems to be coming back. So to me, it really is a good time to buy. Get into the, if you're thinking about it, get into the market soon before inventory goes down, prices go up, or even interest rates go up. If you're selling your home, make sure it's priced appropriately, look at your competition very closely, and make sure your home shows perfectly for every showing. Do you have professional pictures and video showcasing your home to every potential buyer? Every little bit helps in this market. Overall, the lucky homes to sell in July had been listed an average of 63 days, and that's a little more than last year at the same time. In the month, single family homes took 58 days and condos took 69 days to sell in July. Okay, now just for fun, the highest selling detached house in July sold for $1,705,000. That was a 4,220 square foot two-story in Windermere. That's up there. And the highest condominium sale price in July was $1,057,500. And that was an 1,830 square foot home on the 19th floor in Garneau on Saskatchewan Drive. And the condo fee there, just $1,228 a month. I really hope you found this informative. If you have any questions about the real estate market, or you're thinking of buying or selling and you would just like to sit down and discuss your situation, just give me a call. It would be my pleasure to assist you. I hope you have a truly fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.